Maths and nature are very closely related. There are many natural phenomena which involves maths. There is a deep maths in them. It's hidden between them. And when we have to explore those physical phenomena, natural phenomena, we have to develop mathematical tools so that we can study about them in a scientific way. So today we are going to discuss one of such field of physical phenomena, which are waveforms. Waveforms are of many types. Okay, let me tell you one important thing about the waveforms. They have the periodic motion, means they repeat themselves after a certain period. Something about them, some property about them repeats after a certain period of time. Okay, so when we hear a word wave, the picture which comes to our mind is this. This is a wave. You may see it as an ocean wave. This is one full wave from A to B. Why one full wave? Because every particle in this wave has different position. If you see it from Cartesian point of view, Cartesian plane point of view. No? Then you know this is your first quadrant, second, third, fourth. If every ocean wave is seen in that sense, then you can see that when a wave move like this, then every particle has a distinguished position. The coordinates of this point, all of them are somewhat different. Okay, so one complete wave is from this to this. Okay, now if we have to study about ocean wave in somewhat detail, we should have some mathematical way to represent the position of every particle. We'll discuss this afterwards in the video. So this is one full wave, and if we have to make the other wave, so this, it repeats, the wave repeats itself. This is the second wave, B to D. Okay. And this wave-like structure can be seen in pendulum also. Not exactly, but the plot of its motion is also somewhat like wave. How come? Just see. This is a pendulum attached to some fixed point. When we take it to one side and release it, so its motion can be described like this. Okay. Just to differentiate this and this motion, let's call this direction as positive and this is the negative, just to distinguish the two directions. First the pendulum goes here, then it comes this side, then it goes that side, and then it comes back. Then again the same motion starts. We would say ki one period is this, then the next period starts. So it is somewhere like wave only. How come? We can see this with the help of this. First the pendulum was in its mean position. Then its distance from the mean position increases, positive, it increases. Then when we release this positive distance decreases. So we can say this distance is actually first increasing. Then at the extreme position, there is a decrease in, if we take this as the distance from mean position. So this is the distance. So distance from the mean position first increases. Then from when it moves towards the mean position, then that positive distance decreases. Then it's again come to the same position. Then it goes to that direction. Then it goes to that direction. So the negative distance increases. So it's negative distance. You can see this is the negative. It's in the fourth quadrant. So this is the negative distance increases. And then the negative distance decreases. Negative distance decreases and it's again come back to. So here positive distance, then positive distance decreases, then negative distance increases, then negative distance decreases. So it is like a, means the plot of this thing occurring in nature is also of the waveform. Then if we come over to spring, how does a spring behave? This is unstrained spring. Okay, now we are attaching some weight to it. If we pull this, you know the nature of spring. If we pull this to this point, what will go? It will bounce back first. Then it will somewhere, it will show this kind of movement. Okay, so first it's gonna be mean from this. Not from this, but just see the movement. It will go somewhere there. And for a certain period of time, it will stay like that only. Somewhat like that only. Then slowly it go damped, means the oscillation are gonna be like this only. And then slowly, slowly they will damp and they'll somewhat. But they also form a wave-like structure. Okay, when we pull it like that, so it actually oscillates like this. First the oscillations are like this and then it comes to this mean position. Okay, so it's also a wave-like structure. Suppose this is the mean position, so movement around the mean position is like, first it goes in that direction, then it comes back and go in the reverse direction, then it comes back, so one wave is complete. Okay, so there are many more physical phenomena, just like pendulum and spring, which whose plot is waveform. Now, if we have to study about these physical phenomena, so that's basically the job of a physics. But the motion tools are provided by mathematics. Means maths has the responsibility to do the maths part, and that's quite obvious. Now, being math students, it's our responsibility, or it's the responsibility of maths to derive a formula or equation that uniquely describes the position of the particle. Position of the particle, or you can say position of the pendulum. Pendulum. And the position of, or you can say the position of spring. Means if it starts at t equals 0 after 1 minute, what will be the position of a pendulum or the waveform of some particle is here after t equals to itna second, where will the disturbance reach? Okay, so basically many questions can be asked from physics point of view, but we have to give a starting point, the mathematical tool, at least a formula or an equation which specify the position of a particle. Means if the point is here, what's the mathematical formula for this position? Okay. Now, I want to show you something. Just see how a wave actually mirroring a circle. Waveform is actually mirroring a circle. What does this mean? I'll provide this video in the link. You can see it from there also. What's the meaning of this? Let's see. In the video, what has been seen. See, in a wave, these are the different positions of the particle or pendulum or spring. No? And these all positions are actually these. Means the wave is actually mirroring the circle. Means somewhere we can establish some equation. See, when the particle goes from here to here, okay, we can assume it from going here to here. Why? Because the vertical distance is increasing. This is what the video was trying to tell you. The vertical distance was increasing. No? So here also the position, the vertical distance is increasing. Then, this vertical distance of the particle, when the particle moves like this, the vertical distance decreases. And this is the wave which is showing the decrease in vertical. Then we have the vertical decreasing, vertical distance increasing in the negative side. No? So here also, vertical distance of the particle of the wave. Here the wave particle has negative distance and it's increasing. And then finally, we have decrease in the negative distance. Here we have decrease in the negative distance. So wave motion is actually mirroring the circle. So position of each particle can be, position of this particle can be mirrored like this. And position of this particle can be mirrored like this. So somewhere we can establish a formula for the position of the wave particle through the circle. What's the position of this? If we divide the circle into four quadrant, we do have a position for this. Okay. And let's do this. When a wave particle moves around the circle, these are the different positions, and how one position differs from the other, you can see the vertical height and the horizontal distance for this is different from vertical height and the horizontal distance of this. So either of them can be used to represent them, either the height or the what, both are enough. The position of a particle can be, means the position of a particle can be represented by vertical distance. Each particle has a different vertical distance and or the horizontal. So any of them can be chosen as the criteria. Here, if you see, when the particle moves from here to here, suppose the particle is here, what's the horizontal distance right now? This one. If it moves here, so initially when the particle goes from here to here, the horizontal distance decreases. Initially it was maximum, then it decreases. I'm choosing this as the horizontal distance in the y-axis. So the horizontal distance decreases. Then if the particle is here, you can see horizontal distance increases, but in the negative quadrant. This is negative x-axis, no? So the horizontal distance increases, but in the negative quadrant. Then the horizontal distance, the negative horizontal, if the point, what's the horizontal distance? This more negative value, and here less negative value. So negative distance decreases. This is the horizontal distance represented along y-axis. This decreases, and then coming over there, the difference between the horizontal distances of these two particles is, initially the horizontal distance of this was, suppose this is a particle, okay, so it's horizontal distance that actually, initially it was more, it was less, then horizontal distance, then it actually increases again,
the horizontal distance increases.
So either the horizontal property, horizontal distance increasing property, or the whatever, the vertical one, they can be used to specify the position of any particle. I mean, this is a particle whose horizontal distance is this much units.